I'm Charlie Strickland. I'm the one of the lead instructors at Talon Training Group. Today, one of the things we want to talk about is the difference between a Ruger LCP and a KelTec P3AT. This is the 380s. KelTec was obviously around first, and the Ruger came along not about a year ago, which is the time of this video was early 2009. It was released in the SHOT Show a little over a year ago. A year and a couple months now, and orders went through the roof. They pre-sold so many of them, and to this day, as of today's date, the local gun shop, there's still a 3 or 4 month wait on these things. Even KelTecs are hard to get right now. There's a lot of panic buying going on. Politics aside, and, you know, it's their YouTube site, so you can comment if you'd like. We'd prefer not to see a lot of political stuff on here. If it's offensive, we will delete it, but our main goal is to train and to offer products and the things that we know that count. Anyway, the difference between the Ruger LCP, and this is a Ruger, make sure that weapon's clear, and the Ruger LCP, and this one is my personal one through my training company. I've probably put around 1,000 rounds through this weapon. It went back for the recall, and you know, I occasionally have a malfunction. I don't clean it as regularly as I should because it is a range gun, but with proper lube, and it seems to run pretty good. It'll feed most anything through it. Every now and then I'll find something that it wants to choke up on, but all in all, it's a reliable pistol. It is the gun I carry every day. Should probably clean it more. The KelTec is P3AT. Now this particular one has a Crimson Trace laser grip on it, and in a subsequent video I'm going to show the functioning of that. The Crimson Trace laser grip is a different model for the KelTec than it is for the Ruger, but it looks identical. I'm sure they molded the trigger guard slightly different, but if I show one, I'm going to be showing you both, so it's not that big a deal. These weapons, and yes, the Ruger appears to be a direct copy of the KelTec. I don't think there's any doubt about that. But the parts are not interchangeable. I do understand that the slide will come off of one, go on the other. But other than that, these parts don't interchange. Anyway, you can see the difference here. If you add a laser to one, all you're doing is wrapping it around a trigger guard and adding this additional part right here. Can make certain holsters kind of difficult to use them, but all in all, it's really not adding a lot of bulk, a lot of weight to the pistol. Now, at first blush, there's a couple of differences between these pistols. The KelTec has a very textured frame. Quite honestly, it is a very functional gun. Don't get me wrong, but I'm going to critique it here. It tends to look a little rougher. Doesn't seem to be as refined as the Ruger. The magazines, although they look identical, obviously don't interchange. The mag release has some leftover plastic. Looks like from the molding process, and I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but there's the KelTecs as a series tend to look that way. Very functional pistols. I shoot them. I like them, please don't get me wrong, but they're not the prettiest thing in the world. So if you're looking for a nice looking refined gun, this is not the way to go. One thing I noticed from shooting the KelTec, and I shoot a lot. I don't exactly have calluses on my hands from shooting 100,000 rounds a day, but I do shoot a lot. And this gun tends to cut into the skin quite a bit. It can be a little rough. Now, obviously, if it's your gun and you're going to carry it, you could probably take some light grit sandpaper and smooth that out just a little bit, take some of the rough edges off of it. I wouldn't do that if I didn't know anything about guns. It's really not that hard to do. Overall, the edges are pretty smooth. It's not something that's going to snag. This gun can literally be hidden in my hand. If you look at some of our other videos, you'll see that we've got wallet holsters, a number of different options, and we're slowly manufacturing a line of holsters. So as time goes by, I keep checking back. We've got some stuff, cool stuff going on with that. But the breakdown procedure for the guns is the same. You just simply pop down right here this takedown pin, take a knife, slide it inside here. I wouldn't use my good knife for this. Pop this out. When it pops out, then slide just comes off, barrel pops out, magazine, recoil spring guide assembly and all that comes out. If you look at our Ruger LCP cleaning video off of our YouTube site, Talon Training Group, you'll see that the whole cleaning procedures for the Ruger, which is exactly the same from the KelTec. Anyway, on the Ruger, there is a, you pick it up and obviously it's a different feel. The price point is about the same, but again, clear this weapon, which I've cleared several times prior to the video, but I always be careful. The difference in this is this does actually have a slide release on it. There's a slide lock here. On the KelTec, you'll notice that there is not one here. So the slide cannot lock back on the KelTec. Neither of these pistols does a slide lock back on the last round. It just, you've just got to either count or pull until it goes click, and then you know I'm empty and I'm going to put another magazine in there, which I highly recommend you carry a spare magazine anytime. These are only 6+1 capacity. You need an extra mag, especially shooting 380. 380 is a competent round, but it's marginally competent. The terminal ballistics on a 380 are not anywhere near any of the bigger calibers, but it's definitely a capable enough round to carry, especially keeping in mind that I can carry this in my back pocket in a wallet holster, or in my front pocket in a pocket holster, and nobody's going to know it's there. Now, my 1911 or my Glock or my Springfield or whatever it is that I carry, and I carry a lot, I may not have that. It may not be comfortable for me to carry that, but I will put this in just about any pants pocket that I own. Now, the frame on this Ruger is much smoother. It's a lot better feel, much more refined. But all in all, it's about the same. I noticed what I was talking about with the mag release earlier, where it was, you could see the mold, the edges of the mold where it was pressed and all and formed. And no, I'm not an engineer, but this just appears to have a higher quality. No major advantages or disadvantages of one gun over the other. Quite honestly, if I was looking for a gun that looked good, I would wait on the Ruger. If I've got the availability of the KelTec and I can get it before I can get the Ruger, I'd buy the KelTec. Chances are, if you can get your hand on either one of them, buy it. You can sell it if you get the other one that you want later on. It's just not that. These guns are in very much demand. Keeping in mind that these are two of the more capable and the more convenient carry pistols that there are right now. As far as deep cover concealment, that's what our company's mostly about, is training and talking about a deep concealment, actually manageable concealment that you're really going to use. I'm going to do some shooting with these weapons. They're going to shoot the same. The sights on these are both fairly anemic. There's really not a lot of sights to either one, and yeah, that's just the way it is. So they are probably 7-yard and in guns. We qualify with them out to 15, but that's just because we have to by state standards here in Florida. But